everyone, welcome back to the My Glam studio. My name is Ruchita and I'm a makeup expert at My Glam. We have our beautiful model here today. So I'm gonna do a nice blue and black smoky for her with a nice nude lip. So I hope you guys will enjoy the look. So let's get started. So coming to her base, I've already prepped her skin really well with a moisturizer and I've used Total Makeover FF Cream in the shade medium for her. So this is how the palette looks, which comes in with a corrector, a yellow brightener and a foundation. So I'm just gonna go in over with a little bit of more product to give it an even base. So going in with the corrector first. So the orange corrector is something that will help you with cutting down the grayness or ashiness around your dark circles, or if you have any pigmentation around the mouth or if you have any dark spots, it will help you with that. And generally after the orange corrector, people tend to prefer like the second step that comes in is using a concealer over it. But I'm not gonna use any concealer, I will just use the foundation from the Total Makeover FF Cream directly. The reason to do that is the foundation that we have at My Glam already has a primer, SPF 30, concealer and a compact and a foundation itself. So it has everything inbuilt in it. It's more multifunctional. So just the orange corrector and over that I'm going to go in with the foundation directly. So using the foundation now, only wherever required, because as I said, I've already prepped her skin. The palette also has this nice yellow brightener in it. So yellow brightener is something that you can use under the eye area just like a highlighter. So generally a highlighter tends to be something more shimmery which has like a pearly finish to it, but this one is more matte. So if you want something that gives you a highlighted effect on a day-to-day basis and doesn't make it look too shiny, you can just go in with a yellow brightener. Just using the yellow brightener now under the eye area. So basically a concealer and a yellow brightener has two different purposes to it. A concealer is something that helps you with hiding your dark circles, and a yellow brightener is something that will help you with your highlighting. So once you are done with your corrector, then the concealer or a foundation, this is the way I use Total Makeover FF Cream, and then over that you can use the yellow brightener under the eye area and also for the T-zone to give it more of a highlighted finish. So I'm using this nice beauty blender from My Glam to blend in the product. So what I'm doing is I'm just going in with bouncy motions. I'm not sweeping the product out. Beauty blender is something that will take off your excess product and also help you giving a more flawless effect. The second step that comes in after your foundation is using a powder to lock the base in place. So I'm going to use the My Glam's Glow to Glam powder. It's a duo product. It has this nice translucent powder and the shimmer powder. So I'm using the translucent powder for her now. Firstly under her eye area. So the powder that I'm using is absolutely colorless. Doesn't have any color to it. It's very, very lightweight as well. And it will just help to set the base in place and make it last for a longer period of time. Mainly doesn't make your face look very cakey or patchy with the powder. Mainly it will control your excess oil. Do not forget the neck. I have already used the foundation on her neck, so going in with the powder. Your face and neck should never look different. Always make sure you put your foundation on the neckline. Now moving on to her eyes, let's start. So I'm using this All I Need palette from My Glam, which has this nice eyeshadow primer, then it has a eyeshadow which is a royal blue, and it has this nice highlighter as well. So I'm gonna go in with the eyelid primer first. So eyelid primer is absolutely important when it comes to your eye makeup. What it will do is it will make your shadow last for a longer period of time. Also it will help it from not creasing in the lines, and it will give you the true color of the shadow. So generally when you hold a palette, the color looks very different in the palette, and when you apply it on your eyes, it does not look that dark or intense. So if you want that proper intensity, you should use a lip primer. Also, it will protect your eyelids because the skin on your eyes is much more sensitive than the skin on our face. So yeah, now what I'm gonna do is, as I said, it's a royal blue and a black smoky. I'm using the Jet Set Eyes Kajal from My Glam. So I'm just gonna use the kajal on her eyes. Just putting the kajal. It's a nice creamy jet black kajal. It's much proof and waterproof, and it comes in a roll-on. Doing the same thing on the other eye. So basically, I'm putting the black on the entire eye to get the proper intensity of color and also to get the proper black. Blend it in with my finger itself. I feel this makes your job really easy and blends better. You can use brushes as well. Now I'm just taking a blending brush and blending it into her crease. Blending is very important when it comes to your eye makeup to give that soft effect into a crease rather than keeping it more sharp. For the outer corners, I feel I need more intensity of black, so I'm going to go in with more black only in the outer corners, creating a V. I'm not going to smudge this out because I'm going to mix it with the blue. So I'm keeping it intact. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm using the All I Need palette from My Glam, and I'm using this nice royal blue. And what I'm going to do is just patting the blue over the black kajal that I've used. So what happens with the black cream is, it gives you better intensity of the color. I want it to be like a deeper blue. That's the reason I have mixed it with the black. Just putting the blue halfway, not all the way on the entire lid. Smudging it with the black. It's a nice pigmented blue. In one stroke, you get like a nice color. And I'm taking very little product on my brush because I don't want a lot of fallouts. So always remember, when it comes to your eyeshadows, load less product on the brush and then just go in. You can always build it up. I've merged the blue with the black. What I'm going to do next is, I'm taking a blending brush and just blending the black with the blue, firstly in the crease. And for the black that I've used at the outer corners, I want to intensify it more. I don't want to go in with any black shadow over it. I want to intensify and build it more with a cream itself. So I'm going to go in again with the Jet Set Eyes Kajal to create that intensity and mainly to merge it with the blue. Make sure both the colors look merged in each other. They should not look like two different lines of a blue and a black. Now moving on to her lower lash line, I'm just using the Jet Set Eyes Kajal again inside her waterline. Look up. Same kajal I'm putting and sticking very close to her lower lash. Not going all the way in because I don't want her eyes to look smaller. I'm going to use a shader brush again and just smoking it up. I'm just pulling this black all the way till her eye inside, but it will not look too intense. And then I'm just gonna load it with the blue again. For the inner corners, as I said, if you want your eyes to look and appear more bigger, from the same All I Need palette, I'm using the highlighter now. I'm using a Q-tip, just taking the highlighter and using it in her inner corners. So this is how your eyes can instantly start looking more brighter and bigger, and gives a very beautiful look. So now coming to the fallouts, what I'm going to do is just taking a Q-tip and a little bit of makeup remover. I'm just going to go in with my foundation again, just to give it a more even and a finished look. This kind of a bold eye look is carried by a lot of models and actresses for the fashion weeks. You can carry this kind of a nice look for your night parties. Looks really nice. And blue is a color which is absolutely in, and it suits for your different kind of outfits. Mainly on a full black, it looks very nice. And moving on to her eyes again, going in with a nice liquid liner. So I'm using this another product from MyGlam called Stay Defined. It's a duo product. It has a liquid eyeliner and a brow powder. So going in with the liquid liner. It is a nice felt tip liner with a matte finish to it. Sticking very close to the lash line. Almost done with the liner. And as I said, it's a duo product which has the brow powder as well. So I'm using this brow powder on her brows, because brows are very important when it comes to your eye makeup. They make a lot of difference. So starting from the arch, just filling in her gaps. You can see how much difference it will make instantly. For the starting of the brow, don't overdo it. Just be very light-handed. So you can see how much difference it makes by filling in your brows. So now moving on to her face, I'm just gonna contour and highlight quickly for her. So I'm using this another palette from MyGlam called Chisel It in the shade Game Face. It has this highlighter, a blush and a contour. So using the contour for her. The right placement for your contour would be the starting of your ear till where your eye starts. So this would be the placement. And you always have to go in upward direction, so that your face starts looking more chiseled and more lifted. You can use contouring for your jawline. She already has a nice chiseled face, so not overdoing the contour. Her forehead is not very broad, so I'm not doing a lot of it. Going in with the highlighter, just putting it on the bridge of her nose. Because the eyes are so eye-catchy and they have so much color and drama, I'm not putting a lot of highlighter. And then coming to the lips, as I said, it will be like a nice bright eye with a nude lip. So I'm using this lipstick called Terra from the MAC range, the Perfect Curves range. It's a 2-in-1 lipstick. It can be used as a lip liner as well as a lipstick. Is just going in as a lip liner. The right way to apply would be just draw X in the center and go towards the edges. Pull the color in and fill in. So rather than keeping it so matte, I feel I'm going to go in with a little bit of gloss as well, only in the center. So I'm using the Plumping Lip Gloss from the Color Fusion range. A little quick fix for the eye, just going in with a little bit of blue to give it more intensity. Close. A little bit of a black at the outer corner. And you guys can see it, that's my final look, and I hope you guys really liked it and you enjoyed it, and you can definitely try it for any parties that you want to go in for. Also, we tune in live every day on Facebook and Instagram by 4:30. So you can catch us here and you can ask us any queries or any specific looks that you have in your head, and we'll be more than happy to create it for you. We also have our MyGlam application, which you can download and you can learn about more looks, and you can also buy our products over there. This is Ruchita and I'm signing off for the day. Bye.